Today, I'm going to change your everyday lives just by looking differently at platforms that have become ingrained into our society for almost a year now. This idea has consumed me, and it first popped in my head when I was thinking about an online group that I've been following for years called FaZe Clan. My following of FaZe Clan, the deification of a man named Ricky Banks, and let's not forget the hours of reading that led me to this conclusion that social media is a religion. I'm Octavio Lopez, and welcome to my TED Talk. So, I suppose I should explain how an esports entertainment brand and one of their owners led me to this conclusion. Well, they have a team in almost every major video game league, have hundreds of employees, they have collaborated with a wide variety of international clothing brands, have partnered with brands like the likes of Nissan, and through all social media platforms have a combined following of over 120 million followers. Though they are this huge brand now, they were not always. When I was in middle school and high school, I would spend countless hours watching them goof around and dominate in the same games that I played with my friends. And they transformed what most people would consider time wasted into a bond created with my friends who watched them as well. We talked about their videos and waited for them to come out. We watched them religiously. This small group of kids playing video games turned their small following into a giant one. I was able to watch this happen, and one guy in particular who goes by the name of Banks was a big part of coming up with the vision, and I found my young self idolizing this man and group. Once I noticed this idea within myself, I realized many other people have had this one on some level, and then I began to think about it on a bigger scale. This idea is not just about the idolization of one person or even saying that every single person has to idolize someone for this idea to make sense. It is beyond that. Is about how social media becomes such a crucial part of our lives and changes us completely individually and as a society as a whole. The consuming idea of social media as a religion can be polarizing, but if you listen, you'll see how this crazy idea might actually make some sense. First, I need to make a distinction between belief and participation. One does not believe in a religion. Let me explain what I mean. Believing in something leaves the assumption that someone can believe the opposite or leaves room for interpretation. But a religion, regardless of your belief, it does exist. It is inherently so by someone participating and practicing in that religion. If you are a Christian, you are participating in Christianity, and that participation is what changes your shapes and your beliefs. On the other hand, if you were to say you did not believe in Christianity, then you would be wrong. It is, quote, a real religion because people that participate in it. You can, however, choose not to participate in it and not have your beliefs shaped by it. This is the same for social media. You cannot choose to believe in social media. It exists. But you can participate or not. So what is social media? If you're wondering if I'm just still a gamer boy, though I still do play a lot, I'm not. I'm a religious studies major here at UNCCharlotte, and I started thinking about social media because of an internship. And at first, I was just curious about the impact of social media on religion. It's kind of what us religious studies scholars do. We ask a lot of questions. But the more I thought about it in my own use of social media, as I mentioned earlier, I started making these connections between social media and religion. So I began to try to think about what social media really was at its core, and I came to the conclusion that it is that which it is named. It is a media that is social, and it exists within the internet. Essentially, it's a communication system. That may satisfy some as a definition, but not I, because it is so much more. And by thinking about social media within the conceptual framework of a religion, we can begin to better understand it and why it's become such a revolutionary and infectious phenomenon within our society. When I came to the chair of the religious studies department, Dr. Joanne McGuire, with my idea, she asked if I was really ready to tackle the question that every great thinker in the field has tried to answer. What is a religion? She thought I was a little bit crazy. Luckily and unluckily for me, no one can ever really agree on what the definition of a religion is. So here are some of the great historical definitions of religion. First is Friedrich Schleiermacher. Religion is the outcome neither of the fear of death nor of the fear of God. It answers a deep need in man. It is neither a metaphysic nor a morality, but above all, and essentially, an intuition and a feeling. Religion is the miracle of direct relationship with the infinite, and dogmas are the reflection of this miracle. Similarly, belief in God and in personal immortality are not necessarily a part of religion. One can conceive a religion without a God, and it would be pure contemplation of the universe. The desire for personal immortality seems rather to show a lack of religion, since religion assumes a desire to lose oneself in the infinite, rather than to preserve oneself in the finite. That last line really spoke to me for this idea, because that is not Is that not what we're all doing when we post ourselves to this infinite pool of data that is social media? We're becoming a part of the grandiose, never-ending infinity. By using these various platforms, we are interacting with the infinite and hoping to find our corner of comfort. That's what has happened with me over the years with FaZe, and happens to anyone of these YouTube fandoms, Instagram communities, or Twitter stans. A Twitter stan is a term used online to describe a fan who's utterly obsessed with a certain person or group online. There's a lot of them out there. There are whole communities of people who bond over their shared idolization. Which brings me to the next definition. We have William James. Religion is the feelings, acts, and experiences of individual men in their solitude, so far as they apprehend themselves to stand in relation to whatever they may consider the divine. Social media fits into this definition of religion well. When you think about what I just said about these social medias, influencers, and online celebrities who are deified, even if it is not an influencer, your own family who you follow and hold dearly, they could be considered divine to you. Social media, as much as a community that it is still something that you use to contemplate, mostly on your own and in solitude. These platforms are used by people in the bathroom, while waiting in line, while a meeting is going on. It's these little moments of solitude that gives us a feeling of interconnectedness that help us feel a part of something greater than ourselves. And next we have Clifford Geertz. Religion is a system of symbols which acts to establish powerful, persuasive, and long-lasting moods and motivations. By formulating conceptions of a general order of existence and clothing these conceptions with such an aura of factuality that the moods and motivations seem uniquely realistic. To me, this definition works perfectly with social media, and if you replace religion is with social media is, it would make just as much sense. Social media creates our realities and gives us a sense of our world and what we hold to be true. Even the most skeptical people are going to be affected by it, by simply being a part of it. It is a simple psychological fact that we're going to be affected by our surroundings, digital or not. If one has a constant access to a stream of personalized content and information, it is going to change how they see the world. So, as you can see with these few examples, the more I read, the more social media seemed to fit the bill. Then I came across Assad in Religious Studies 2600. Shout out to my teacher, Priya. I like Talal Assad because I am very much paraphrasing his argument, and his definition was essentially, who cares? And let me clarify before my professors kill me. His argument explains how every definition of religion and every religion itself is a product of its historical, societal, and economic context and the power dynamics at play during that time. And it's impossible to separate the definition or the religion from this context. So, we should not worry about coming up with a universal definition of religion, and instead focus on the power dynamics and the context within which it exists. If we wanted to focus on the power dynamics, we would look at our societal governments across the world. They work in different ways depending on the country or region. But here in the US, our capitalistic society shifts the power away from the majority of people through a disproportionate distribution of wealth. And social media has become a way to level that playing field. Everyone seems more equal, and it allows for everyone and anyone to have an opportunity to have a voice. Within this power context, we can see why social media has become so widespread. What really got me going about this idea, though, was in the way that social media shapes the reality of every individual that practices using it. By using social media, one is inserting themselves into something that exists beyond themselves. When people read the information on Twitter, Facebook, Snapchat, or any other social media, it is slowly changing how they see their world. Every piece of information, whatever it may be, on this constant and refreshing basis, is slowly changing your perception of the world. One who uses social media will see the world as this interconnected space, which would be fundamentally different than someone who doesn't practice using social media. I compare this to someone who grows up practicing a traditional religion and reads the sacred text throughout their life. This constant intake of information is going to differentiate how they look at the world and compare it to someone who doesn't practice that religion. It's going to be completely different. They will grow to see the universe and the world in a fashion in which the religion teaches them. The same is of each social media and each person that gets a personalized intake of information that they can take and consume and have their reality shaped by practicing it. Each person can pick if the reality will be filled of politics, sports, memes, entertainment, or even porn. This choice shapes what we are constantly seeing, and what we see is what our reality is. helping in shaping that reality are influencers or celebrities, or both. I would compare social media influencers to priests, monks, nuns. They are just people like everyone else, except they have a congregation of people that listen to what they have to say and can be idolized for whatever message they decide is worthy of being spread. These people are deified and become larger than life. People will find who they like and agree with, similar to people finding their congregations in traditional religions. Like when I follow Faith Banks, I found a person who spoke to my values as a person, and he to me was an idol because I sought to be like him, in that he has been able to be successful by making his passion into a scalable business. He's going against the status quo, and I admire it. I'm sure there are some of you who follow people on social media and you wished and or aspire to be like them. On the flip side, if you consider yourself religious, I'm sure there's someone like a priest or a member of your church that you wish you could be more like when it comes to being a quote good practitioner of religion. I know a lot of people who aspire to be as good of a person as Jesus Christ, and that is a perfect example. When you think of a religion, what do you think about? A church maybe, a holy book, maybe daily prayer, meditation, yearly holidays, communion. These are all rituals. Well, how many of you wake up and immediately check your phone to catch up on your social media? Or start walking to the bathroom, but turn around because you forgot your phone? Post a story every time a close friend has a birthday? Every time you have a really beautiful meal, do you snap a picture? Or watch a YouTuber as soon as he posts his vlog at 3 p.m. every Wednesday? All of these are rituals of sorts, and they are ways of connecting ourselves to other people through something that is greater than ourselves. These events cause real feelings and experiences to the individuals practicing them. When these posts go up and people respond, people have made themselves of this community to make themselves feel connected. This is a huge part of why religion has been constant throughout human history. You may feel irked by me calling social media religious, but I ask you to question why it irks you. Why do you have this preconceived notion of what religion should be? Religion before even 100 years ago was limited to only a belief system with a god, and only some scholars in the West allowed multiple gods when thinking about religion. Now, you'll be hard-pressed to find anyone who thinks Buddhism or Taoism isn't a religion or have religious attributions, and there's no god that is needed for the belief as a fundamental practice. All I want to do today is to get you to question the way you look at religion, and beyond that, question the way you look at things in your everyday life. What you might find is that there's more to some things than meets the eye, and that's how we evolve as academics, a society, and a species. Phase up.